100 yards to go. Durasa counter in front. It's coming home in second. Elegant Escape on the outside of the conditional. But it is Durasa counter who's won the Ladbroke Trophy.
Emma, the Ladbrokes Winter Festival is nearly upon us again. And last year, you not only took the big prize, the Ladbroke Trophy itself, you also took the long distance hurdle with Paisley Park. How did that feel?
It was just amazing. It was so hard to explain. It was the most amazing day. It was exciting. And to think that you know, it was us that had the picture of the two horses with their red Ladbroke sponsored rugs on. You know, you see that for the big yards, and it was just a really special weekend.
How did it feel for the team afterwards? The buzz must have been amazing.
It was. I think it was the buzz from Friday into Saturday was fantastic. We went out and celebrated Friday. Then for Saturday, it was, you know, to think that we could go and do it again. I have to say, I don't think Sunday and Monday were quite so exciting. Everyone was kind of dragging their feet around the yard. But it's what it's about. It's you know, those are the dream days. And there are plenty of others that aren't like that. So when it does happen, it is magical, and it was a very, very special period. It really was.
It's such an important meeting to National Hunt fans of racing in general every year, particularly so this year. It's something to really, really look forward to, isn't it?
It is. I mean, clearly nothing is normal at the moment, and it's tough. It's tough for everybody. I mean, from our point of view, we're able to sort of continue to operate in a relatively normal way, insofar as everyone's coming into work and the horses are working as normal. But for our owners, clearly for racing supporters that want to go and enjoy the day out, it isn't the same. And I think these big days, it's something to look forward to, something to be excited about, big weekends. And so I think it will be so good for everybody to actually have, you know, a big festival and something to really get their teeth into. And I think why coverage is going to be so important, so that it sort of, you know, people feel like they're there even if they're not.
So Durasa counter, he's got an entry again this year. How is he?
Touchwood, he's great. He has done the same as we did last year. It was very much the plan with him last year, and we gave him a run over hurdles to have him spot on, and then went for the big race. And we've done the same again this year. We had him ready a little bit earlier this year, so we went to Newton Abbott a week earlier than going to Uttoxeter, and he ran an absolute stormer there. He gave 2.5 stone to the horse that beat him. He finished second. I was delighted with him. And so it's sort of onwards and upwards from there with all roads leading to the Ladbroke.
What sort of attributes does a horse need to compete in these brilliant staying handicaps?
I think the key attribute that these horses need is the ability to travel and jump. Mm. You know, the race is run at a high tempo, they're beautiful fences at Newbury, but they're big fences, and you just need to be able to travel and get into that rhythm and jump. And I think to not be afraid of big fields. You know, you have some horses that prefer smaller fields. They're probably not ideal for the hurly-burly of a race like that. But yeah, I'd say that the key ingredient, they need to be good, but they need to be able to travel and jump.
He certainly did that last year, and he was always in a good position. And then he took it up at the cross fence, and he looks to be going so strongly, but that's a long way from home there, isn't it?
Absolutely. And I have to say, we were all thinking the same.
Right. But
he was travelling so well, and I think Ben felt that, you know, he didn't want to take anything away from him and just let him roll. And you know, he rolled all the way to the line. There was definitely a moment of thinking, oh my God, it is a long, long way from home. But he had the horse underneath him, and he knew what he had underneath him, and it was fantastic.
So, unlike Paisley Park, is it a case of, with him, you know that you're looking at the end of season festivals and kind of working backwards, even though you're winning big prizes along the way? With Durasa counter, is it very much a case that this is the main target, and then you work on from there?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think for us last year, it was very much the main target. This was what our focus was absolutely on that race. And it had been from when he won the novice handicap at Uttoxeter at the end of the season before. We were like, right, we are going to all roads lead to the Ladbroke. And I suppose we then thought after we'd won that you know, was he going to be a Gold Cup horse? And he kind of got unlucky, because I'd say he's a horse that probably does like the slightly better ground. And once it started raining, it never stopped. So I don't think we got to see the true him after the Ladbroke thereafter. And I suppose the same thing again this year is that all roads lead to the Ladbroke. It's a massive prize. It's a prestigious race. And in fairness, you know, he owes us nothing from winning one. If he could win another, it would be extraordinary. But I think, you know, that is his Gold Cup, and we'll see what happens after that.
What's he like to actually train?
He is, he's not always straightforward. He's probably getting better as he's getting older. He just thinks life is a bit of a joke. So he's one that eats his dinner, throws his feed pot out the window, expects you to go around and get it back in again. When there's a lot going on in the barn, he can be quite busy. So when, you know, like, no, you can't put a bridle on me because I'm going to face the other way, you know. So he's a bit of a joker. But when he's out and he's galloping, he's always a good workhorse. He's always a good traveller. You'd always pick him out when he's trotting in the school because he's a great mover. When you go to do something different with him, you know, he can be a little bit of a plonker and sort of say, no, actually, I'm going that way. But you just work with him, you know. Right. You'd never bully him. You'd always just work with him. And if you work with him, you know, he'd do anything for you. He's as tough as they come.
How is Paisley?
Well, touch wood, Paisley is in flying form. Clearly, we had a big scare at Cheltenham with his heart, and I'm just delighted that that he has got over that and got over it of his own accord. Although he went to Newmarket, there was no intervention necessary. He had righted the irregularity of his heart of his own accord. And I think that's pretty significant going forward, that had happened for himself rather than having to give him anything to do that. He's had a great summer. He came in looking really fat and well, typical Paisley style. But he's come straight back into his work. We've monitored him closely with no issues, and touch wood, we're well on the way to heading back to Newbury as his target first run. He's doing everything right. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll get there and still be doing everything right.
It does show what an achievement his continued form and level of success was, that horses are so fragile. And to do what he's done already, and he's still a young horse, it just shows what an incredible talent he is, doesn't it?
Absolutely. I mean, he's as hard as nails when he's got his game head on and he's at the races. You know, all he wants to do is try for you. And we're so lucky. He's a pleasure to have here, and to, as you say, have achieved what he's already achieved. He's just, you know, it would be lovely to be able to keep going. And he is a young horse, and certainly his work. You know, he did his first bit of work on the grass last week, and just, you ask him just to quicken, and he's like off and going, and he's a horse of a lifetime, and hopefully he will just keep rewarding us.
The finish last year in the long distance hurdle you're going back to, I think that's the sort of finish which epitomises national hunt racing. You've got the reigning staying hurdler up against Thistle Crack, who had gone to win in King George once he'd gone over fences, and even in seeing that horse for your second, fans were delighted, but we're also so delighted to see you win. It just shows this meeting means so much to so many people, the sorts of horses that you have running there.
Absolutely, and I think it's one of the amazing things about national hunt racing and why it is so different is the fact that the horses come back year on year, and it's just... it's great to see them, and you know, even seeing Thistlecrack in the stable yard beforehand and walking on down the walkway, you know, we as sort of fellow trainers are looking at him thinking, God, wow, isn't he just the most special horse that's been around for so long? And you know, he's sort of one of our heroes. And then vice versa, you know, there are other people stopping and taking pictures of Paisley as he's walking down. And to think that we're involved in a horse like that is extraordinary, and just, you know, great for everybody here. And you're right, you know, those kind of finishes in staying hurdles, staying races full stop. They definitely get our hearts beating anyway, and look, that's what racing is about.